In no particular order, here are a few of the most insane millionaire playboys. Number 8, Jeffrey Bokia, the Prince of Brunei. Have you guys ever heard of Prince Jeffrey Bokia? No? Well, he's the brother of the Sultan of Brunei. Anytime your title is a prince, you most likely have a ton of money, or at least have access to a ton of money. Prince Jeffrey isn't an exception, and he loved to spend that money. At one point, he was reportedly spending an estimated $50 million a month. That's just insane. So what are some of the things he's doing to spend that much money? Well, let's start off by mentioning he owned a collection of over 2,300 cars that was composed of Bentleys, Ferraris, and Rolls Royces. That collection of cars make his collection of 5 boats and 8 private jets seem small by comparison. But let's talk about his fleet of boats real quick. One of his yachts is named Tits, with its tenders named Nipple 1 and Nipple 2. This guy sound insane to you guys yet? Another example of him blowing through money was him paying $17 million for Michael Jackson to perform for his 50th birthday. Oh wait, that's not really that ridiculous, right? But wait, in order to have Michael Jackson perform, he needs a stadium. So, he had a stadium custom built for Michael to perform at. At least he was nice enough to make the concert free for the people in his country. We can go on and on with some of the more typical purchases rich people make, such as thousands of custom-made Versace and Armani suits, or the over 150 homes he owned in 12 different countries. But what takes the cake has to be the custom statues he's built of himself and his wives performing, let's just call it, morning cardio, that he put on display at one of his houses. Seriously, who does this? However, Prince Jeffrey probably had to rein back the spending just a little after authorities discovered that Jeffrey had personally blown through $14.8 billion from a government oil investment fund he was overseeing. But if you're asking us, he's probably still doing what he's doing. Number 7, Dan Bilzerian. If you've been on Instagram for 5 minutes, you've probably seen Dan Bilzerian floating around. Dan is probably the most famous male Instagram celebrity who plays poker, shoots guns, and hangs out with a bunch of strippers. He's been given the unofficial title as Instagram's most interesting man. If you hop on his account, you'll see anything from him making big bets in casinos, or he may be boxing at the gym with Floyd Mayweather. His net worth is estimated at around $150 million, but who knows what that figure actually is? Who even really knows how that money came to be? Because even though he claims to have made his money from poker, people that play poker in the nosebleed stakes like to call Bilzerian's claim a bluff. However, and wherever he got his money, we don't care, because we do enjoy seeing his crazy antics on Instagram. He's thrown an adult film actress off a roof, breaking her foot. He's wakeboarded with his cat on his head. He's biked from Vegas to LA just to try to win a prop bet against his friend Bill Perkins. Some people like to hate on his lifestyle and try to say that he pays for all his women. But you know what? We don't care. Keep the crazy antics coming, because at least they're entertaining and do more than just show off money. Is there a more fitting king of Instagram? Let us know in the comments section. Number 6, Tony Totoni. Tony Totoni is a 40-something-year-old businessman who openly admits to trying to be the next Dan Bilzerian. He's known for his trademark middle finger, which is what he uses to authenticate his posts are his. He actually insured that middle finger for $7 million. Anyone wanna punch this guy in the face yet? Well, that's actually what he's trying to make people feel. Because according to his own words, he made a lot of money so he can carelessly enjoy his life while pissing everyone off. Totoni comes off like a complete idiot when you judge him through his photos only, but his backstory is at least interesting, and it shows that there's more to him than just what he shows through Instagram. He's apparently enjoying his flashy lifestyle because he works plenty hard for it, starting with fleeing Iran with his parents for a better life. Tony made his money supposedly in real estate, and with the money he's made, he's trying to outdo Dan Bilzerian. His pictures essentially just show him with either money or women, or a combination of both, along with his middle finger. All his pictures seem to just be trying to get a rise out of haters with the usual money and women without any real creativity. Come on, Tony, we know you can do better. Number 5. Gianluca Vacchi. Multi-millionaire entrepreneur Gianluca Vacchi isn't your average Instagram guy just trying to show off. He's a silver-haired 51-year-old Italian playboy and heir to a manufacturing empire. He's the type of dude to show off his newest dance moves, do a flip off a yacht, or show off what his workout that day may be. Having semi-retired from a career in his semi-business, Gianluca first took off when a video he posted of himself dancing on vacation with his then-girlfriend, Italian model Giorgia Gabrielle, went viral. He's since gained a huge Instagram following, as he now has over 11 million followers. His lifestyle definitely divides opinions out there, but one thing's for sure, a scroll through his feed is definitely entertaining. According to him, he's no longer interested in making money because he says he's worked hard from 25 to 45. Stacking that cash simply isn't his priority anymore, and he's just interested in satisfying his curiosity in the world around him. He wants to be a global entertainer and a celebrity through showing how he lives his life, and it certainly seems like he's having a ton of fun doing exactly that. Number 4. James Stunt. If you've ever heard the name James Stunt before, that's probably because you're American and you're into F1 racing. He was married to Petra Ecclestone, daughter of Formula One racing tycoon Bernie Ecclestone, and heiress to the $5 billion Ecclestone fortune. The key word here is was, because they've had a nasty divorce battle. Anyways, Stunt has a strangely private life, and there's not much that's known about him. Everything people know about him is just from the media and paparazzi. What he's known for is spending massive amounts of money. How he actually made his money is a mystery. His former in-laws even were left scratching their heads at how he has money. He says he made his first £4 million at the age of 16, involved in an oil trade he barely understood. That's Jay Gatsby-esque. No one really knows who he was until very recently. He rolls around with bodyguards and an entourage. Okay, that's Floyd Mayweather-esque. He likes to do things big and show it off to people that's there for the scene. He's been seen giving homeless people wads of cash while leaving a trendy restaurant or club. That's Robin Hood-esque in giving back to the people. He's in charity auctions and balls outbidding other rich people for causes he believes in. That's pretty Bruce Wayne-esque if you're asking us. Even if it's a true mystery how he is actually able to sustain a lifestyle that involves fleets of Lambos and Phantoms, all the while having only publicly known business ventures be failures or be barely profitable, one thing that's for sure is that he's doing it in style. Number 3. Travers Bainin. 46-year-old playboy Travers Bainin is said to be the Australian version of Dan Bilzerian, and as expected, Dan Bilzerian isn't happy about it. It's probably because he doesn't want to be associated with someone that would walk their wife around on a leash just for a pic on Instagram. So, who is Travers Bainin? He's a former Australian football player who has millions, being the heir to a tobacco retail empire. He apparently also was a pretty successful model in Australia. Today, he's known for wild parties that he documents on Instagram, an account filled with the usual exotic cars and women. However, he actually has a wife and 2 kids. His wife seems to be totally fine with him parading around other women and huge parties, but hey, as long as she's cool with it, that's all that matters. Bainin is known for his legendary parties at his quote, candy shop mansion, and he's popularly referred to as the Candyman. We're not quite sure whether someone gave him that nickname or he came up with it himself. His Instagram is filled with pictures of cars and girls in bikinis, sprinkled in with pictures of him and his kids. It seems to be a little bit weird to have kids grow up in that environment, but hey, it's not our kids, that's all we can say. Number 2. King of Thailand. Ever since the death of Thailand's revered king, King Bhumibol, the country has had a growing anxiety over its fate. King Bhumibol was the longest reigning monarch in Thai history, reigning over 70 years and 126 days. He was such a revered king that many people actually believed him to be divine. The current king, King Vajiralongkorn, hasn't exactly lived up to his dad's reputation, and he certainly hasn't earned the trust of the Thai people. Prince Vajiralongkorn has spent much of his time lapping up a luxurious lifestyle in the mountains of southern Germany and Austria, using fast cars, women, and a billion-dollar empire to pass the time. He's been married 3 times, the first of which was to his cousin. However, he got involved with another woman that he had 5 children with, and he ended up marrying her in the end. But that also didn't end well. Aside from the crazy family issues he's had, he just seems weird in general. He's been captured on film while with his 3rd wife, practically naked, celebrating a birthday party with formally dressed servants around. So, what was the party for? His poodle named Air Chief Marshall. In 2017, pictures of the new king showed him in the Munich airport wearing a small white crop top with jeans. Okay, we're not gonna endorse his fashion choices, and apparently he doesn't either, because when pictures of him wearing the crop top hit the internet, he threatened to sue Facebook if they didn't take down the photos. Number 1. Cooper Hefner. When your dad is essentially the original Playboy legend for all the Playboys of today, you know you have a lot to live up to if you try to replicate his lifestyle. Cooper Hefner plans to continue his dad's legacy into the future as best he can. Cooper grew up in the Playboy mansion and has seen the mansion operate firsthand, so it's no surprise that he's set to take the reins of the family business. Cooper has an older brother, Marston, and 2 half-siblings, Christy and David. Christy Hefner was previously involved with the family business, acting as chairman and CEO, until she stepped down in 2009. Today, Hefner works as the chief creative officer of Playboy Enterprises beginning in July of 2016. One of his first priorities was to reinstate nudity that Playboy had gotten rid of, so that what his dad built was authentic. Well, in addition to making sure Playboy is still making money, he makes sure he has fun as well. There's poker night with Playboy bunnies at the company headquarters, there's the fast cars and access to the Playboy private jet, then there's all the travel and schmoozing with celebrities. And don't forget he's also engaged to British actress Scarlett Byrne. Maybe his lifestyle isn't as insane as the other Playboys on this list, but rather insanely stable, yet cool at the same time. Here's what's next.